It's fun to be here. I always like getting to come out to the press conferences, and you hope that the weeks you get invited, that the team does something exciting. And this had to have been one of the best weeks in Wisconsin softball since our staff's been here to go 4-1 on the week and win two big ranked games at Minnesota, and then take the series at Iowa. It was just a fun, unbelievable week for this team. We're kind of a growing squad, so good week to come and say hello.
Is this kind of what you expected, Yvette, from this team?
I think this team's making some really great strides. We started the season and we really were resetting our goals to say, let's work on making the Big Ten tournament. Let's take baby steps of growing. And from where we were at in the fall to where we are now, I think it's been more than baby steps. So I'm really pleased with the progress. It's hard to get ranked wins ever, and this is one of those years where we've had some tough losses, but there's just been a lot of ranked wins, and I think that's it's always an amazing thing, and I just think it's kind of being at Wisconsin that you see it happening all around you, and it makes it seem more attainable and more realistic. But in the grand scope of things, you don't see that many ranked wins, so I'm enjoying it.
What's the biggest thing you think you guys need to improve on as you look forward this week?
We're getting a lot out of our young players. I think we're making some progress right now. We went from really struggling last year to having great moments of greatness this year. Of course, every coach would love to be more consistent. You know, I think we will have a big win and then we'll have a tough loss. So that would be great to see, but it's a tall order to go from not winning as many games to saying you want to sweep teams. But, you know, we're all competitive and we all get a little we get a little greedy. So, you know, you go out to Iowa and you take 2 out of 3, and I think everybody wanted the sweep there, but it's tough to sweep anybody. So I'm pretty pleased. If we could see a more consistent performance, that would be great. But, I mean, going into our last 13 games, 11 of the teams are ranked in the top 50. So we've got our work cut out for us.
Coach, I have two questions, if you don't mind. First one, after I think a couple of weeks of it not being so nice out, softball conditions, does this week kind of feel like a breath of relief, maybe, like we finally have some good weather?
Oh, absolutely. It's funny that, you know, we'll come out and talk to the media now and this week, and some people say, oh, you guys are just starting your season. And for us, we are in the home stretch. I mean, we're, you know, that's 5 Big Ten series down, 3 to go, and 5 weeks on the road before that. So we're 10 weeks into our season right now, you know, heading into the last couple, and it's just starting to get nice. So it's fine if everybody's just starting to get into the spring spirit right now. It'd be the perfect time with the spring football and us playing at home the same weekend is usually a really fun family weekend that we see a lot of families coming out and going to the family activities at McLean before, and then kind of wandering over to Goodman along the lake and doing that. So we're ready for the weather.
And also Taylor Page Stewart, obviously she's a senior this year. Have you seen her kind of mature over the past couple of seasons?
Taylor is a great story. She's another one that, a senior biochem major, pitcher, you don't see many student athletes that are just that driven and, well, you see them here, but highly intelligent and just amazing young women. And she's made so many strides from last year to this year and just in her career that she is just, she's a perfectionist and she's smart and she's found a way to have more fun this year. And I think it's made all the difference. So when you see Taylor laughing on the mound and smiling, she's able to put together a week like she did this week, that she got the win at Minnesota, she had a save at Minnesota, and 2 wins at Iowa. I mean, you don't see many All-American pitchers having weeks like that. So we're really proud of her as a senior to do that.
You mentioned those bounce back wins. I think last Sunday against Purdue is probably one of the tougher losses you had. Do you think that kind of gave you, your team, a little bit of edge heading into Minnesota?
It did give us edge, but I can tell you from a staff standpoint, that's a scary loss, because every emotional scary loss, you know that you could lose your team at that point. It's late, you lose tough games, you lose games that you think you should win, you lose them late, and you're always worried that the buy-in will go away. And we've really just been riding them of believe, keep working hard, it's going to pay off. And it's been an investment, and they're they're playing well. And the fun thing is we've got some seniors that haven't been the hero throughout their career. They were here for the Big Ten Championship their freshman year. They went to the NCAAs their sophomore year, but they were more role players and, you know, in and out of the games. And those kids are coming up, and Katie Christner's hitting home runs at Minnesota, and Macy Oswald, who hasn't really played a ton in her career, is having huge RBIs, and Taylor's the star on the mound, and Ashley Van Zeelen, our other senior, has been in the lineup since, you know, all 4 years as a walk-on. But I think it's all about the seniors right now.
Anything else, Brian?
Just being at home here too, you know, obviously you can be comfortable and what have you, but you don't want to take that for granted either, right?
No, being at home is tough for a sport like us, honestly, because we play on the road so much. So our three Big Ten series so far on the road, we've won those three. And the two at home, we split with Ohio State and we lost to Purdue. So it's an advantage, but at the same time, when you don't play a ton of your games at home, when, you know, you're going to see a lot on the road, you've got to find a way to play well at home. So we're hoping this many games, the team gets comfortable and finds that groove, but we haven't done it yet. Having a lot of fans helps. So typically this Get to Goodman weekend, you get a lot of fans, a lot of kids, a lot of cheering kids, and we do a free kids clinic, and it's there's a lot of really fun stuff. And those games, historically, we've had some just phenomenal games. So we're hoping that the fan support helps kind of push them to get that home edge.